To watch the latest from India Science, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press on the bell icon to get notifications on all the science-related videos.
Humans are a force to reckon with today. But we were not always like that. We started out being insignificant. Sometime during our evolution, we managed to rise through the ranks. Today, we wield so much power that our actions are threatening the planet. So how did we get here? And how did we outlive our closest human relatives, Neanderthals? Before Neanderthals disappeared about 40,000 years ago, they inhabited Eurasia. We don't know what drove them and other human species to extinction. Was it us? Did we outcompete them due to our more developed brains? Or was it sheer bad luck? Unfortunately, the Neanderthal brain is not well preserved in fossil records. So scientists had to turn to another tool that would help them recreate the Neanderthal brain, or at least a part of it, in the lab. Helping them achieve this is a gene editing tool called CRISPR-Cas9. Dr. Emmanuel Charpentier and Dr. Jennifer Doudna won the Nobel Prize in 2020 for bringing this technology to light. Using this technology, researchers from the University of California, San Diego, introduced a Neanderthal version of the gene named Nova1 into human pluripotent stem cells, which are capable of developing into any cell type. Humans have a different version of Nova gene. This gene helps form the brain synapses or nerve junctions, a site where neurons communicate with each other. Scientists then grew these modified cells into organoids or miniature organs. What they saw was striking in terms of growth and shape. The Neanderthal-like organoids were shaped like popcorn, as opposed to the more round ones found in modern-day humans. What's more, the ancient organoids multiplied more slowly. It is important to remember that organoids don't wholly represent the human brain, but it has provided some fresh insights on Neanderthals. Speaking about these findings, the lead researcher Alison Muttori told New Scientist that modern humans might have reaped benefits out of the latest version of the gene. He added, "If I might speculate, it might suggest that individuals carrying the Neanderthal Nova1 alteration have a potentially different way to process information, and thereby their survival."